visiting St. Edmund's Church. At first glance, St. Leonard's is like any other church, but below, there's a crypt with a rather gruesome secret. This kind of mystery is really not for the faint-hearted, and some viewers may be shocked by what you're about to see. Mike Pearson is the man in the know.
So this is the entrance to the crypt, which is underneath the chancel at the main chancel.
You
can see what's here and how impressive it is with the skulls and the bones, particularly in this main stone.
The remains of about 2,000 bodies are collected here, but no one knows exactly why. Past historians argued bones were placed in the crypt after removal from the graveyard when the church chancel was extended in the 13th century. And as other cemeteries nearby became full, remains were dug up and placed here to make way for new graves. This practice in itself was not unusual in England, but the bones were usually dispersed, making this a rare collection.
It's quite staggering. It looks, I don't know, it's weird to all these.
Yes.
The bones were stacked this way in the early 20th century to preserve them.
Do you think they all died peacefully?
The original theories were that they were warriors slain in battle. But because researchers recently have studied the skulls, they found that there were slightly more females than males. And there was an absence of wounds generally, so they're not warriors at all.
Although the skulls and bones belong to people long since passed away, they still tell a story of the lifestyle that they lived.
They did have a hard life. And for example, in terms of the teeth, here's an example of teeth where the teeth are very worn, and that's because of the coarse diet.
Right.
But they do not have holes, so that shows that there was an absence of sugar, but it does explain how hard, although it's a hard life, the teeth were preserved compared with modern day teeth.
Researchers have been studying and cataloguing the remains, and alas, not everyone died peacefully of natural causes.
That's called sharp force trauma, where
Yes.
So in actual fact, a sharp implement has been driven through the skull. Now, whether that was in warfare or just a fight, we don't know.
And this probably killed.
And this probably would have killed, although the way that has healed means that
cause of death? Diet and disease are some of the many things that have been discovered from recent research, but the question of why they were all collected here is still an open case.
It's so strange, but it's very uncomfortable.
Yes.
Holding a skull from a dead person.
It is, when you first do it, you do get used to it. I can well understand how you feel that way. And we have to recognise everyone in this room is just a person.
And it's fascinating. It tells us so much about the past, doesn't it?
It does. So that we have a glimpse of how they lived and what they suffered from.
Thank you, Mike. I wasn't expecting to be able to do this kind of day, but it's been absolutely fascinating. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure. Thank you very much.